From the Tribune News Network, this is Newsbreak. I'm Krishna Russell. Seven asylum seekers, including a mother who was separated from her young child for over a year, were yesterday released from the Carmichael Road Detention Center after being detained at the facility since May 2019. Their releases came nearly 3 weeks after Calendars & Co. filed an action against the government ordering them to prove that it acted lawfully when officials detained the refugees who sought to take refuge in the country after fleeing Cameroon over fear of persecution. At the time, a Supreme Court judge granted Fred Smith QC leave to issue a writ of habeas corpus against Attorney General Carl Bethel, Immigration Minister Ellsworth Johnson, Immigration Director Clarence Russell, and Peter Joseph, the officer in charge of the Carmichael Road Detention Center, who were in turn given until April 7th to file a return, explaining the reasons the asylum seekers had been detained indefinitely. The Tribune understands the return was never filed. However, during a virtual hearing before Justice Bernard Turner, Keith Cargill, the attorney representing the respondents, said the government had made arrangements to release the refugees. After spending nearly 2 years in custody, the detainees were finally allowed to walk out of the gates of the detention center shortly before 2 p.m. yesterday. Infectious disease expert Dr. Nakia Forbes said the benefits of taking the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine still far outweighs the risks associated with the jab. Her comments during a Ministry of Health press conference yesterday came after the United Kingdom announced that it will offer AstraZeneca alternatives to adults under 30 after European regulators identified a possible link to rare blood clots. Chief Medical Officer Dr. Pearl McMillan said local health officials became aware of the UK decision just yesterday and will monitor the science on the matter. Meanwhile, Dr. McMillan said a small number of people who have been vaccinated in the country have reported non-serious and mild side effects. With the country's economy showing promising signs of recovery, Director of Labor John Pinder has estimated the unemployment rate is now around 20-23%. Last year, Mr. Pinder estimated that the jobless rate was around 40% due to the coronavirus pandemic. He said, quote, "A number of businesses have been opened since then, and so we are satisfied that the number is down in the mid-20s. Yesterday, Mr. Pinder also said he believes most hotel properties that closed due to the pandemic will have reopened by midsummer. However, he said this also depended on the country continuing to see an increase in tourist arrivals, as was seen last month. The union representing hotel line staff has said an estimated 75% of workers remain furloughed despite an increase in visitor arrivals. Bahamas Hotel Catering and Allied Workers Union President Darren Woods said the majority of the 6,000 workers in his union are wary of the ongoing pandemic-induced situation, while tourism officials celebrate increased visitor arrivals. Earlier this week, Tourism Minister Dionisio de Aguilar said that 60,000 non-residents bought travel health visas to visit the country in March, double the number that did so in December 2020. It is believed that the number of travel visas purchased roughly corresponds to the number of arrivals in the country. The figure for March represents a 92% decline compared to arrivals in March 2019. Yesterday, Mr. Wood said the reported uptick has not translated to the same number of people in hotels. Your complete news and information source, this is the Tribune News Network. In international news, President Joe Biden, in his first gun control measures since taking office, announced a half-dozen executive actions Thursday aimed at addressing a proliferation of gun violence across the nation that he called an epidemic and an international embarrassment. Biden said during remarks at the White House, quote, "The idea that we have so many people dying every single day from gun violence in America is a blemish on our character as a nation." Family members whose children were killed at the Sandy Hook, Connecticut school massacre in 2012 and the shooting at Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School in Parkland, Florida in 2018 attended the hearing, and Biden thanked them for attending, saying he understood it would remind them of the awful days when they got the calls. Nations around the world set new records Thursday for COVID-19 deaths and new coronavirus infections, and the disease surged even in some countries that have kept the virus in check. In the United States, Michigan has averaged more than 7,000 new cases a day. Brazil this week became just the third country after the U.S. and Peru to report a 24-hour tally of COVID-19 deaths that exceeded 4,000. India hit a peak of almost 127,000 new cases in 24 hours, and Iran set a new coronavirus infection record for the third straight day, reporting nearly 22,600 new cases. The Tribune's AccuWeather update, a service of Bahamas Power and Light Company. High pressure centered north of the area will continue to dominate the weather across the Bahamas. For all areas, it'll be variably cloudy and warm, with a slight chance of an isolated shower or two through tonight. Winds east to southeast at 10 to 15 knots, but falling light and variable at times in the northwest Bahamas, and 10 to 15 knots in the central and southeast Bahamas. Seas 2 to 4 feet over the ocean in the northwest Bahamas, and 2 to 4 feet in the central and southeast Bahamas. We'll have a daytime high temperature of 81 degrees and an overnight low temperature of 63. The sun will set this afternoon at 7:27 and will rise tomorrow morning at 6:54. That's Newsbreak. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper, now on the streets, or stay up to date online at Tribune242.com.